lift up your arms right now. Just welcome him with banners of praise. We invite you. We open up the gates with praise.
Yeah. one more time. Go on and tell him he give you the highest praise. You deserve it all, Jesus. Everything and everything we have.
Shout of praise right now. Can we just give him a shout of praise? Come on. Let's just thank him. He's so amazing. He's so good. Come on, we can just do better. Just give him a massive shout of praise. But he's good. He's amazing. He's still the same yesterday, today, forever. He's the Alpha and Omega. He's just amazing. Praise God. Wow. Man, I just love Sunday nights. I particularly love baptismal Sunday nights. Just amazing. Can we just welcome our friends as they come on stage tonight? We're going to do this as best we can tonight. Won't you find your seats as we introduce our friends? Tonight we have our friends. We're in the back room. We're having a great time in the Holy Ghost. And to be honest with you, as a pastor here at Bethel, it's one of our great privileges that to be able to be in the journey of someone being baptized. And I want to say tonight, at the simplest form, it's an outward expression of an internal transformation tonight. And the reality is, the simplistic form is this: I've decided to follow Jesus, and I'm continuing to say yes, and tonight is confirmation of that continued yes. Can we just give these guys one more round of applause? So amazing. I love it. Excuse my swimming attire, by the way. I never jump in a pool without closed feet. So anyways, just a thing with me. Anyways, we're gonna try this. We understand this side. I'm going to ask you guys your name and why you're being baptized tonight. And sweetheart, we're going to start with you. Would you tell us your name and why you're being baptized tonight?
My name is Audrey, and I'm getting baptized tonight because I was born to do it.
Come on, Audrey. Thank you so much, my friend. Your name and why you're being baptized tonight?
My name is Noah, and I'm getting baptized tonight because God died on the cross for me.
Wow. Thank you, Isaiah. Would you guys go down this way? Praise God. Would you tell us your name and why you're being baptized tonight?
My name is Olivia. I believe in Jesus and God, so, you know, let me know. Let me die in water.
Come on. So amazing. So proud of you. Why don't you take it this way? Thank you so much. Yeah, you go ahead. Tell us your name and why you're being baptized tonight.
My name's Darian. I'm being baptized because I want to give my life to Jesus.
Wow, come on. Just that continued yes to the yes that they said when they gave their life to Jesus. That's amazing. Why don't you tell us your name and why you're being baptized tonight, my friend?
My name is Rachel. This is my second time to get baptized. Holy Spirit just asked me to baptize today, so I just follow.
Come on, complete obedience and saying yes. Well done, that's amazing. Thank you so much. Why don't you go to Nathan this way? My friend, your name, and why are you being baptized tonight?
My name is Harmon. I'm just being baptized because I felt led by the Holy Spirit too. So, and I'm ready just to lay my life down for him fully.
Wow, that's it. Well done, mate. Thank you so much. You can go this way. My friend, I love this guy. Why don't you tell us your name and why you're being baptized tonight, my friend?
My name is Peter. And I'm being baptized because I'm in love with Jesus Christ. And I vow to walk in his glory for all the rest of my days.
Yes. Can we just give Jesus a hand clap? That's amazing. Come on, bro. You go this way. Roy, why don't you tell me your name and why you're being baptized tonight?
I'm Brendan. And I'm being rebaptized because I love Jesus with all my heart. And I want to declare to all of you that he's my all in all.
So good. Thank you, bud. Troy drove 18 hours in the snow from Denver a few days ago to be in our services here this weekend. So... I just said your name, but why don't you tell us your name and why you're being baptized tonight?
My name is Troy Strickland, and I'm being baptized because I'm going to take off the armor of the old man, and I'm going to rise up, and I'm going to have a new life in Christ with the new man. And I'm taking it back to Colorado.
Yes, come on. So good. Wow. What did you tell us your name and why being baptized tonight?
My name is Andrea, and I'm being baptized because I want more of Jesus and more of the Holy Spirit, and I want to follow him with my whole heart.
Wow, it's amazing. Thank you, sweetie. So powerful. Why don't you come over here? What was your name and why are you being baptized tonight?
My name is Janice. I am being baptized today as a sign of radical obedience, and I want more of the Holy Spirit.
Come on, so good. Thank you, Janice. What a privilege. My friend, your name and why are you being baptized tonight?
My name's Gage Green. I feel like I have a weight and I'm drowning. I just want to break it.
Come on, come on. You get to live again. It's a resurrected life. Thanks, bro. Why don't you come down? Why don't you tell us your name and why are you being baptized tonight?
My name is Tila, and I've waited a really long time for today, and I love Jesus, and I'm ready to live for him, and not myself.
So proud of you. Why don't you go over there? So good. Hey, my friend, why don't you tell us your name and why you're being baptized tonight?
I'm Judah, and I want to get baptized because I love Jesus with all my heart.
So good. Well, why don't you stand on your feet? Here at Bethel, during the worship, we get to celebrate with our friends as they go down in the tank. And I remember that when I was 17 years old, getting baptized in a pool after Sunday service at a Sunday lunch in Australia. And the feeling of people watching me and affirming me that I'm saying yes to follow Jesus and making a public declaration. Again, what they're doing is they're making an outward proclamation of their inward transformation. They're following Jesus. And it's so amazing. Why don't you lift your hands as we go back into worship? I believe tonight there's going to be a lot of supernatural turnarounds, a lot of supernatural things happening. And that's what we've been prepping our friends as they get baptized tonight, that when they go under the water and they come out, they come out with full of power, and that the Holy Spirit would fall on them in a totally different way. And that's our prayer for you tonight. Again, why don't you just begin to speak in tongues? Why don't you lift your hands? Begin to speak in tongues, and our friends will take us back in.
could search all the earth below and never find another like you, another like you. There's no other more beautiful. I'll never find another like you, another like you. There's no other more wonderful. I'll never find another like you. Oh.
There's no one who is like the Lord.
Oh, In the darkness we were waiting, without hope, without light, till from heaven you came running. There was mercy in your eyes to fulfill the law and prophets. To a virgin came the word from a throne of endless glory, to a cradle in the dirt. And praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit, three in one, God of glory, majesty, praise forever to the King of Kings.
Shouts of praise to him. Put his name on your lips. Put the name of Jesus on your lips. I love, love, love the Christmas gospel. The Christmas gospel. Isn't it beautiful? Here's what I want you to do tonight. I came in with a thought, and the thought didn't go away during worship. There's one chapter that gets me every year. I mean, the book gets me every year, nearly every day. But there's one chapter at Christmas that gets me. Matthew chapter 2. Jesus will be out of Egypt, out of Bethlehem, and a Nazarene. Can you imagine talking about that before Christmas? And going, how is this going to happen? How can he be out of Egypt? How can he be out of Bethlehem? How can he be a Nazarene? But all three, here's what I want us to do tonight. Every one of us have places in our lives that don't make sense. Conflicting prophecies, circumstances. Here's what I want you to do. I want you to put the things that don't make sense in your left hand. And I want you to hold them down here. And then what I want you to do is I want you to take the prophetic words and the promises, and I want you to put them in your right hand. And I want you to begin to lift them up. With the words that we've sung tonight, you reign above it all. You reign above it all. I could search the whole earth and I'd never find another one like you, because you reign above it all. And I want to give you highest praises. Just hold those words for a moment. Hold even the confusion for a moment and go, you reign above it all. Keep that posture. Keep the things that don't make sense in your left hand. And keep the prophecies and the promises in your right hand. As we close out and sing again, you reign above it all.
Jesus, you reign above it all. You reign above it all. You reign above it all. Over the universe and over every heart, there is no higher name. And Jesus, you reign above.
Sing it again.
You reign above it all.
Declare, he's going to work this out. Just begin to declare, he's going to work this out. Egypt, Bethlehem, Nazareth, all three. All three, the odds are ridiculous, but all three fulfilled in Jesus. He's going to work this out because he reigns above it all. He reigns above it all. Just speak hope into that person next to you. Declare it. Declare it. I can't tell you how many times my wife says this to me. He's either who he says he is, Paul, or he isn't. She says it to me all the time. Circumstance after circumstance. Just speak that over the person. Speak this, though. Speak the positive. He is who he says he is. He is. He really is. Lift up shouts of praise to him and bless his name. Give him highest praises once again. He is the King of the Jews that the wise men looked for. He is the one from Egypt. He is the one from Bethlehem. He is the Nazarene.